Hello dear students, today we are going to talk about electrothermal atomizers. Atomizers I have already discussed with you, and I assume you must be knowing by now that atomizers are that component of an atomic absorption spectrophotometer which involve conversion of our sample into atoms, because this type of spectroscopy basically involves irradiation of atoms. So our analyte, our sample which is to be studied, should be in atomic state for them to absorb light radiation for absorption as well as for emission. So in this context, you have already studied about flame atomizers. Those atomizers basically involve, they use flame to convert our sample to atoms. Today we are going to study another type of atomizers, which are electrothermal atomizers. These are known as furnace, also electrothermal furnace. These are electrically heated. They involve heating of the sample using electricity. By electrically, they are heated to such high temperatures that our sample gets broken down, it gets dissociated into atomic state. These atomizers are more sensitive and they require less sample in comparison to our flame atomizers. So electrothermal atomizers, as name itself suggests, is that heating electrically. You must be having this material with you. Here I have drawn a schematic diagram of electrothermal atomizers. This is not exactly how an electrothermal atomizer looks like, but it shows that what are the main components, how are they arranged in an electrothermal atomizer. So what happens, that electrothermal atomizer basically consists of a graphite tube in the center. This is the main part where all the action takes place. This graphite tube has two windows on both the sides, and this is the optical path through which light passes. So you have a lamp here, hollow cathode lamp, which produces radiation of our desired wavelengths, and they pass through our sample and they go onto the monochromator and detector and readout devices and so on. So our electrothermal atomizer has a graphite tube which has holes, different holes for different purposes. There's a port for sample here. So there's a place where sample is kept, this particular place where sample is deposited. So what happens, that this tube is covered by a metal jacket, in which here water, it keeps circulating, cool water keeps circulating so as to keep the temperature of the instrument overall low, because we are dealing with very high temperature here. So in between water and graphite tube, there is inert gas. So inert gas is between water and tube also. That means it's around the tube as well as inside the tube. The inner part of the tube is also flushed with inert gas. So there are different openings through which gas enters into the tube and around the tube. So there is a removable window also. So our electrothermal atomizer, main parts of the electrothermal atomizers are these only: water inlet, outlet, metal jacket, and inert gas. So a stream of inert gas passes through it. So what happens, that when we place sample here on this particular port meant for sample is introduced here, and what happens that electrical connection is provided, and this particular tube, it starts heating up. When temperatures increased, first of all, it gets in different stages. First of all, drying of sample takes place. Our sample, it gets absolutely bone dry. There are no traces of water whatsoever. Next step is ashing. That means our sample is completely ashed, oxides extra, completely they are combusted, and there are no such things. Unoxidized, there's nothing unoxidized. Complete ashing takes place, and after that there's an increase in temperature. Temperatures go very high, It depends upon exact temperature, depends upon our requirement. You see, different type of analytes, they require different temperatures. And same was in flame atomizers also. I told you there also that it depends upon the our sample, that what temperature, what fuel oxidant mixture we will use to produce the temperature of the flame. And here also, it depends upon our analyte, our sample under study, that at what temperature do we require. So what happens that after that, when temperature increases, our molecules, they break down, they dissociate into atomic state. And when they break down into atomic state, they get irradiated by light. So what they do, they absorb light and they go to higher energy states. So, and when this particular light, whatever is left of it, is passes through this particular window and it goes to monochromator and detector, which then analyzes that what wavelengths have been absorbed, and they correspond to a certain the wavelengths we already know. So we can easily make out that this particular wavelength has been absorbed or that particular wavelength has been absorbed. So our sample is containing this element or that element. So the amount of absorption also indicates the concentration of the atom or element in question. So another thing is that this is a very good atomizer. As I already told you, that it's more sensitive, it's better than flame atomizer from this point of view, that it requires less sample. At times, having amount of sample in your what you have is a very important question, because at times you have very less sample of a particular substance. So here electrothermal atomizers, they require less sample. The thing is that the sample, the lifetime of sample in this tube is few seconds in this case of electrothermal atomizers, but in case of flame atomizers, it is less than 1 second. So the sample gets exhausted very fast. So you don't have much time to irradiate or all the sample. But in case of this electrothermal atomizer, sample stays in the tube for some time. So atoms, they have time to absorb the light, and majority of atoms, you know, population of atoms which gets excited to higher energy state is more. So that is why this is more sensitive and it requires lesser sample. That is the reason, because the lifetime of sample in this particular tube is more. So this is about the electrothermal atomizers. They are also part of the larger picture. They are just atomizers. Here is a lamp, here's atomizer, light passes through the atomizer, it goes to the monochromator, then to the detector. That part is same in all the spectroscopy. That part is always same: lamp, monochromator and detectors, they are also the same. This part only deals with the preparation of sample for this study. So you can also make out on your own what differences do you find in flame atomizers and electrothermal atomizers.